هلو، ويز يو دكتور هبة فوزي، وي ويل كونتينيو ويز ذا ابيثيليال تيشو، ذا سكند ليكتشر. اوكي، توداي وي ويل توك اباوت ذا ريمينينج تايبس اوف ابيثيليوم. وي هاف ديسكاست ذا تايبس اوف ابيثيليوم. اوكي، توداي وي ويل توك اباوت ذا two types which are neuroepithelium and myoepithelium. We have discussed surface epithelium and glandular epithelium. Okay. Today neuroepithelium, as we know, is a special type of epithelium which is modified to receive stimuli of some sensation and convert them into electrical impulse. Neuroepithelium have a special characteristic. Okay, it has three types of cells, which are sensory cells for receiving the stimuli, supporting cell, and basal cell. Usually, supporting cell are present at the periphery to protect. Its function is to support and protect the cells, while the basal cell, from their name, are basally located and are responsible for renewal and replacement of other two types. So they act as stem cells. Where we can find the neuroepithelium? They are found in the taste buds for sensation of taste. Also, they are found in olfactory mucosa for smell sensation. And for in inner ear, in organ of Corti for hear sensation. Also in ear for sense of equilibrium. Okay, يبقى they are epithelium modified to receive stimuli. Here we can find the structure of taste bud, which is a type of neuroepithelium present in tongue. They are onion shaped and surrounded by stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, and this onion shaped structure is the taste bud, is formed of the three layers we have mentioned, which are sensory, which are related to nerve fibers, and basal, which is basal in position and act as a stem cell, and the peripheral one, which is supporting cell. Also present in the olfactory epithelium for sensation of smell, and the inner ear for hearing and equilibrium. Okay, the last type of epithelium is the myoepithelium, which is specialized for contraction. Okay. It's a basket-like cell with several processes. We call it basket cell. It contains actin and myosin and intermediate filament, and present surrounding the excretory portion of exocrine cells. By their contraction, they help to squeeze secretion into the ducts. Okay. Here we can see the basket-like cell or basket cell surrounding the excretory portion. Okay, to squeeze by contraction, to squeeze the secretion and force it into the duct. Then we can conclude the function of epithelium in it responsible for protection of underlying tissues and for transcellular transport molecule across epithelial layer, usually thin layer. So this function is specialized for simple squamous. Okay, it's responsible also for absorption of material from albumin, like intestinal epithelium, and for secretion of mucus, hormones, enzymes. Okay, it control material movement between body compartment, and for detection of sensation, like neuroepithelium. Then, when I ask you about the epithelium suitable for exchange of gas and metabolites. Which one of this epithelium? Simple columnar or simple squamous or stratified squamous or transitional epithelium? The right answer is B, simple squamous. Okay, it's the suitable one because it's thin and the thin wall help for exchange of gases and metabolites. Okay. Stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, non-keratinized, okay, can be found in palm of hand, non-keratinized, okay, no keratin, or stomach, or urinary bladder, or mouth cavity. As we mentioned in the previous lecture, it's present squamous non-keratinized in wet surfaces, so it lines the mouth cavity, while epithelium lining the urinary bladder is the uroepithelium, which is transitional epithelium, while that of the stomach is columnar epithelium, and the palm of the hand is the skin, so it's stratified squamous keratinized. So right answer is D. All are feature of epithelial tissue except it's formed of cells with minimal intercellular substance. Cells lie on a basement membrane. Cells are penetrated by blood vessels. Cells undergo continuous turnover. The right answer is cells are penetrated by blood vessels. As we know, the epithelium is avascular, while it's usually formed mainly cellular and contain minimal intercellular substance, and all cells lie but cells lie on basement membrane, which is separated from underlying connective tissue, and also cells undergo continuous turnover. Okay, the type of gland in which part of the actual cell break away in order to release its product. Part of the cell, part, not the whole cell. So it's apocrine or holocrine or merocrine or endocrine. The right answer is apocrine. Only part of the cell is lost. Okay, not the whole cell. In case of the whole cell or wall cell rupture or lost, but this is holocrine. And merocrine secretes secretion by exocytosis. And endocrine, this is a gland with no duct. It secretes secretion directly into the bloodstream. Okay, then we will talk about the polarity and specialization of epithelial cell surfaces. Polarity is a structure and functional asymmetry. It's a characteristic of epithelial cell. Each, okay, of different three surfaces of the epithelium show different structure to adapt their function. Okay, so we have apical surface, basal surface, lateral surface. We can divide them into apical surface specialization and basolateral surface specialization. Okay, we will take today apical surface specialization. Okay, here we can see the epithelial cell not symmetrical, surfaces not symmetrical. Apical part has different criteria from lateral and basal part. Okay, apical specialization here are in the form of cilia, flagella, and microvilli, and stereocilia. Okay, so we will discuss the apical specialization in today's lecture. While the basal surface shows other specialization. Okay, but specialization of epithelial surface are divided into apical surface, which will divide them into cilia and flagella, and stereocilia and microvilli, and into basolateral surface, okay which show other specialization which are cell junction, lateral interdigitation, basal lamina and basal membrane infoldings. Okay, today we will concentrate with apical surface microvilli. As we mentioned, microvilli responsible for increasing the surface area. Okay, as in absorptive columnar epithelium of the small intestine. Okay, while the cilia responsible for movement or sweep like movement in one direction to get rid of mucus, excess mucus or any foreign subject, as in respiratory epithelium. The actin microfilament present in the core of the microvilli are attached to the underlying terminal web present basal to the microvilli in the apical surface of the cell. Okay. Here we can compare between cilia and microvilli. The cilia composed, as we mentioned, of microtubule arranged as 9 doublets with 2 central singlets with dynein arms attached to the doublets. This is the structure of the shaft. While the basal body is identical to the structure of centriole, which is formed of 27 microtubules arranged as 9 triplets with no central singlets. Okay. While the microvilli is composed, the core is composed of actin microfilament attached to the cell membrane by myosin filament, okay, and attached to the underlying terminal web. Not true cilia. Stereocilia are immotile cilia, not true cilia, not movable, okay. They are long microvilli. They present in the lining of epididymis and vas deferens of the male genital system to increase the surface area for fluid absorption. Okay, يبقى stereocilia is like microvilli but it's longer in length. Okay, not motile, so it's immotile cilia. Because it's long, يبقى it's immotile cilia, but the core is formed of actin like microvilli. Stereocilia are not cilia. They are very long and irregular microvilli. They are found in male reproductive tract to increase the surface area for fluid absorption. Then, when I ask you about apical surface of epithelial cell, may be provided by microvilli, cilia, stereocilia, or all of the above. The right answer is all of the above. Okay. In ciliated cells, mitochondria are concentrated in apical part, lower part, equally distributed in the cytoplasm or around the nucleus. Cilia is movable structure. It need energy. So mitochondria lying near to the cilia. So it's present in the apical part. Okay. Which of the following statement about cilia is true? They possess a 9 plus 0 configuration of microtubules. They don't contain an axoneme. They contain ciliary dynein arm. They are nearly identical to centrioles. They play major function in absorption. The right answer here, we can take each choice and think about it. Are they possess 9 plus 0? No, it possess 9 plus 2. Okay, 9 doublet plus 2. Okay, no axoneme in the cilia. That's false because cilia is composed of 3 parts, which are rootlets, basal body, and axoneme or shaft. They contain ciliary dynein arm. This is true. There is dynein arm which is responsible for the movement. which is motor protein responsible for the movement of the cilia. يبقى the right answer is C. They are nearly identical to the centrioles. Which part of the cilia identical to the centriole? Not all cilia. Only the basal body. But basal body present in large amount per cell. While the centriole, only we have two centrioles in the cell. Okay? One pair of centrioles. They play a major function absorption? No. It's not the function of the cilia. Okay? It's movable structure. Not the function of cilia is absorption. But the right answer is C. They contain ciliary dynein arms. Microvilli. Here we see a transmission electron microscope photo of apical surface of a cell containing many microvilli. Okay. They are finger-like projection. Okay. The core is composed of actin microfilament. Here we ask you about microvilli. A, facilitate absorption, contain core of keratin intermediate filament. Totally wrong. It contains actin, not keratin. They are generally considered to be localized on the lateral surface of epithelial cell, not lateral surface. They are apical specialization. Has a core containing 9 peripheral doublet of microtubules? No, no microtubules in the microvilli. So the right answer is A. It facilitates absorption. Increase the surface area to facilitate absorption. Concerning the core, okay, of shaft of cilium, it has 9 central microtubules, 9 singlets, okay, and 2 microtubule doublets, 9 singlets, okay. It has a consistent number of longitudinal microtubule arranged as 9+2. It has bundle of actin. It's composed of 9 peripheral triplet and no central singlet. Okay, لا 9 peripheral triplet and no central singlet is the structure of basal body not shaft. Okay, يبقى دي is false. Composed of bundle of actin. No, actin is the internal structure of microvilli, not shaft of cilium. So the right answer is B. It has a consistent number of longitudinal microtubule which arranged as 9+2. So we have taken today the apical surface of specialization of epithelial cell, which may be cilia or flagella or stereocilia or microvilli. The next lecture we will discuss the basolateral surface specialization, which are cell junction and lateral interdigitation on the lateral surface, and basal lamina and the basal membrane enfolding in the basal surface. So to conclude, the apical surface of the epithelial cell may show cilia, flagella, microvilli, or stereocilia.